With Finnevere's Art Alchemy line having grown to include Metalik, Opal Magic, and the new Sparks paint, I thought it was time to compare the three to see what the differences are and how to best take advantage of them. Light surfaces and dark, journal pages and cards, even on a gel press plate, Art Alchemy paints are versatile, include a lot of interesting colors and effects, and are a worthwhile addition to your studio. One of the best ways to know a product is to experiment and test it. And my beginning steps here with these three paints was to create swatch cards. And you'll notice that I've done them on both black and white. Now, I started with the mindset that because Opal Magic is more or less an interference style paint where you see one color depending on how the light is reflecting and you might see something else, again, in a different lighting situation or depending on what color surface it's on, I felt like swatching them in black was important. But having said that, I was actually pretty surprised to see what the Metalik and the new Sparks paint did on black. So when you talk about Opal Magic, there's actually two groups within the Opal Magic line. One of them is a color and gold. So there's rose gold, there's blue gold, there's green gold. And I will bring those swatch cards in very quickly. You can see them here. And when you look at the interference effect on the black, you'll notice that these are all gold. But the color that you see, the color that you see on white is completely different. The other half of that is the ones that are something else. And by that I mean that they're actually a duo color, they're two-tone. So you see you have yellow-blue, and here you're seeing the blue on the black. That's your interference color. Sparks and Metalik are completely different from Opal Magic. There is no interference effect from them. They simply are what they are. So with Metalik, you get something that looks very much like a metallic paint. Whatever the particulate matter is that's in there that makes this look metallic, it is small enough and probably of a different kind than what's in the Sparks, so that what you see is a pretty uniform surface. It's reasonably opaque. This was a couple of brush strokes on black, which is always good to know. And you'll notice that it has a fairly similar appearance. It's glossy, so you can see it reflecting in the light, but it does have that traditional metal style look that you think of when you think of a metallic paint. Sparks is an entirely different animal. You'll notice, first of all, that again, it's a glossy surface, but I'm hoping that you'll be able to see this. The particulate matter, whatever is in here that makes it sparkly, is quite different than what's in Metalik. And so you can see little individual sparkles. Now they are all crammed together, obviously, but unlike the Metalik that presents a very smooth look, you can see the sparkles in the Sparks paint. And it too is really works really well on black. You can see that it's fairly opaque. Again, just a couple of brush strokes gets me this. But where I really thought it was interesting, and this happened by accident, was when I lifted up with the bristles and I got this very light feathery stuff at the end. It's really apparent on the Sparks. It looks very interesting, which is not to say that it's not on the Metalik. I just didn't do that much of it. But you can see here and here where that effect is actually quite different. So as we start to play with these, and I have an itty-bitty accordion book that I've done a little bit of work on, and I'm going to show you them on the gel press plate, you'll see that these paints all are very different. I pulled a pink from each of the three options within the Art Alchemy line. So for Opal Magic, I have Aqua Rose, Vintage Rose is the Metalik color, and in the Sparks part of the line, I chose Butterfly Spells. And then I went through and I basically swatched them using our Bubble Blast stencil. Again, you can see they've all got that kind of glimmery finish. Lighter here because we're talking about the interference style, a little bit more opaque, or quite a bit more opaque here because, again, we're talking about that metallic style of paint where you're going to see smooth metallic look. And then on the spark side, you can see, again, lots of glimmer, but you've got that sparkly effect because we're talking about different particles that are in that paint. So you can do anything with these paints that you're going to do with any paints, bearing in mind that you're going to get slightly different effects when you work with the Opal Magic on dark or black. So what I've done, this is one of our itty-bitty 2-inch accordion books, and you can see that it hasn't been folded yet. And let me zoom back out here a little bit. It has not been folded yet, but what I have done is used a brayer and brought out some of the colors. This is primarily Sparks. So the first thing that I did, this is Vintage Rose in the Metalik line. Again, you see that kind of smooth, luminous, metallic look. Everything else is the Sparks paint. All of this, as I sort of go down the line here, All of this was applied with a brayer. What I'm going to do next, so this is one of our itty bitty accordion books. This is the newer 4-inch style. What I'm going to do now is come back to that same bubble blast stencil, but this time I want to show you what happens when I start to apply these colors through the stencil. Now I'm working on a surface that's not completely white. It's got colors on it already. I've come in with some colors of dilutions and I've sprayed. So first up is going to be Opal Magic, and obviously too much paint through a stencil is never a good thing. So I'm just going to pick up a little bit from the cover and I'm going to start putting the color down here. This is the one that you'll probably see the least effect from, because again, we're talking about an interference color and I'm not working real dark. If I hold this up, you can certainly see some of the colors. So I'm going to get far more subtle effects with this. I'm going to switch now to the Metallique. Whoops, is that Metallique? Let's see what I've got here. Yep, so this is the Metallique, and this is the Vintage Rose color in Metallique. Again, too much paint, not a good thing, so I'm going to be cautious about how much I add there. And now I'm going to come over here, and I'm going to do essentially the same thing, but you're going to see right away, well, maybe I do need a little bit more paint. You're going to see right away that I'm going to see more of this color, because it has a tendency to be more opaque, bearing in mind that I'm working on very similar colors here to begin with. I mean, I've kept everything that I'm doing pretty much on the warm side of the color wheel. That's my aim for this particular piece. So you can see definite, more definite of the pattern of the stencil, and it's certainly more opaque. So let's slide down a little bit further here. I'm going to knock some things over when I do it. And then I'm going to grab the mini ink blending tool that I had the Sparks color on, and I just stuck my finger in a whole pile of paint. So hold on one second while I wipe it off. Okay, so coming back to the Sparks, again, I'm going to do the same thing, make sure I've got enough paint, but not too much. And now I'll come over here and I'll start applying the Sparks through the stencil. Completely different look, and this is what's so nice about these paints, is that you can get very different looks depending on what it is that you're doing. So again, you can see I've got more opacity here because this is not an interference style paint. But what you'll discover as you use these is that they are marvelous. I can't say enough good things about them and how many interesting things you can do with them. The last thing I'm going to show you, I'm going to drag out a 5x7 gel press plate and quickly do a print with each of the paints. Using the Art Alchemy paints on a gel press plate provides lots of different and very interesting results. What you see here were two colors of Opal Magic. This is the violet green, and this was done with the pink blue. You can see how very different they look. So let's start with the violet green. You can see that the interference color is the violet. That's what you're going to see most of. You'll notice there's a little bit of debris under there. I printed this after I printed this, and so there's a little bit of the other color showing through. Whenever you pick up that stuff, whenever you get that sort of debris that's hanging around on the plate, that creates interesting effects, and obviously combining it with the interference effects of the paint is also really cool. So on the, again, I want to get this right, on the pink blue, you're definitely seeing the pink color here as the interference against the black. So let's bring that 5x7 plate in. Again, there's debris on here. This is interference paint that's left over. I'm not going to pick that up. I'm just going to leave it alone and see what happens. So let me grab some of the Sparks paint. This is Fairy Wings, which is a really cool greeny color. I'm going to grab my brayer and a stencil. So I used, this is the Curvaceous stencil. This is one of our Joggle stencils, and you're probably familiar with this. This is our Endless stencil. I'm actually going to work with that right now. So I'm just going to put some of the green out here. Now, this is a pretty light-bodied paint, similar in body to something like Lumiere, and so it's not super heavy. You'll feel a slight difference when you brayer it out onto your plate, but there's nothing bad about that. I'm just letting you know that it is slightly different. So again, I've got a nice thin layer out here. Now I'm going to do just very simple things here just to show you the process. So I'm going to drop the Endless stencil on here. Just grab a piece of paper and pick up some of the color through the openings of the stencil. This one I'm going to print on black. I've got a piece of black paper right here, but you can see how awesome that effect is, that sparkle effect, just from what I printed through the stencil opening. So let me take this off, put that there for a moment, and just bring in a piece of black paper and go ahead and print this. And again, how awesome is that? You get all of that wonderful sparkle. I have to tell you, I was a big fan of the Metalik, but the more I work with the sparks, the more I realize how much I actually like it. So let's go ahead and do something very similar, but this time let me bring in, this is Mermaid Sparkle. Let me bring some of this in and put some of that out on the plate. Notice again, I'm leaving what's left from the prior prints there. That's not quite enough paint. Actually, you know what? Let's bring in a little bit of the green and mix these up and see what happens. Who says we have to just stick with one color? So let's get these blended on the plate, and this time I'll print on white. This is our Love Twist stencil, so I'll bring that one in. Grab a piece of paper. Again, I just want to pick up the color that's in the openings of the stencil. And this time I'm going to actually spend a moment and pick up a little bit more, so that that stencil design is really evident. This time I'll grab a piece of white, and you can see that this is just as cool on white as it was on black. Now these are not super dark colors, so there's not going to be a ton of contrast here, but there are darker ones in there, and how awesome is that? Sorry, let's get the glare out of the way. You can see, I didn't do enough green in here, but you can get the effect. There's no other way to describe the paint as sparkly, and so the name Sparks is perfect for it. So the last thing I want to do is bring in a couple of colors of the Metalik. So this is Vintage Rose. This is one of my favorite colors. Let's wipe the green off my palette knife. Go ahead and put some out here. And you know what? Let's get crazy. Let's combine it with a little bit of the Sparks and see what happens. Again, who says we have to follow any particular path here? We can just play however we want. All right, so that Sparks might have kind of overwhelmed it, so I might need to come back and do this again. So let's throw the stencil around. Let's bring Endless back in. Grab a different piece of paper to pick up the color through the stencil openings. And this is part of the play process. This is how you make mistakes and discover things. Serendipity comes into play here. You can't discount the importance of play. It's something that I would encourage you to do as regularly as possible. Oh, so there's the pink in there. You can see it's very subtle in here. That's actually a really interesting and a nice look. Let's just try two colors of Metalik now. Let's bring in this darker pink. This one is called Pink Blush. So I'll come back with the Vintage Rose and then add some of the Pink Blush. And this will be the last thing I do for you today. I will say it again and again as often as I can. I am a big admirer of these paints, and I know that the sparkle ones are ones that I'm going to be using quite frequently because they are just awesome in terms of how much sparkle you do get from them. All right, so last thing, let's just pick up this color through the openings of the Love Twist stencil, print it, and see what it looks like. See what kind of debris we get, too. Oh, see how cool that is? So I've picked up some of the leftovers from within there. I've got a nice blending of those two colors. So this was Metalik. As I said a moment ago, no matter how you use these, I think you're going to find that they're simply marvelous for all kinds of creative endeavors.